Now there's a data reference type called PyPointArray, in which you can define an array of Py tags. Now, this isn't something that you see used a great deal because currently our client applications do not support this, so you can't make use of this in PyProcessBook or DataLink or PyWebParts. But you can create it and inspect it in System Explorer, and if you're a developer and you're using our SDKs, you can get access to that array. In fact, we have an example we'd be glad to share with you. So let's say, for example, I'm looking at the, there's some pressures in the all the different pumps. I'd like to see them as an array of results. So for my data reference, instead of simply one Py point, I'm going to choose a Py point array. Now, I'd better make sure that I have an array type here that I can use. Yeah, the default would have been a single. I'm going to change this to a single array. And now I'll go out and choose the Py tag. So I'll do a tag search. And let me just go ahead and reset this. I'm looking for all of the, these are the Houston pumps. Yeah, here they are. There's six Py tags. We can take a look at their current values right here. I'll go ahead and say OK. And as you can see, there's a format that we're using to specify more than one tag. And I'll go ahead and say OK. And now this is being returned as a single array. Now, I can't make use of it in any of our client applications, but as you can see, this is something that's being returned as an array of values. You can control what is returned, just like on the regular Py point data reference. If I wanted to bring in an aggregate, say averages or something for that array, we could do that as well. And that would be done through these retrieval methods here. But that's an option for you that's available. It is available programmatically to you. Now, if you are interested in more hearing more about that, what I'd suggest you do is contact our tech support. They have some sample code that you can take a look at. Call number 318-576 is what you can ask them about. We haven't published it generally yet, but that's something you may see on vCampus soon, and that's an option for you if you are interested in programmatically getting access to that array result. Again, that call number would be 318-576.